This video is a beginner's tutorial about cloud storage. We will look into few important things about this. What is cloud storage? Why you should consider storing your important files on cloud? What are the important factors which we should take into account when selecting a cloud storage provider? And what are our best free cloud storage options? All this is coming up in this video. So let's get started. Hello, my name is Tahir, and if this is your first time, please hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell to get notified whenever I post a new video every Tuesday and Friday. Now, what is cloud storage? Cloud storage simply means storing your files on a computer which is physically somewhere else. For example, you can store your files on Google's computer. You can store your files on Microsoft computer. A Dropbox computer. So these companies are physically located somewhere else, but they give you the ability to store your files on their computer. So cloud is a computer network which is connected to the internet. So this is your cloud storage. Why you should consider storing on cloud? So there are few reasons. Two are the reasons which are for every person like you and me. And the third reason is normally for businesses. So what is the number one reason? The number one reason is that we want to make sure that our important files are saved. If, for example, our hard drive malfunctions, so we will lose our files or most of the files. There are options to recover, but sometimes it doesn't work. So we want to make sure that our files are stored on Google's computer or some other computer. Similarly, if you lose your laptop, if you lose your tablet, if you lose your phone, if you are not storing your files on some cloud storage, all your data will be lost. So this is number one reason. And the second important reason is that we want to access our files all around the world. If we are traveling to another city or to another country, we want to access our files. We cannot access our computer because it is not with us all the time. We might not take our laptop with us, but we still want to access our files. Number third reason is that some companies and some businesses, they also want to manipulate their files. For example, I will give you a very common example of Netflix. So this is a video streaming service. So they want to store their files somewhere from where they can stream their videos on auto or on demand. Similarly, a company is in installing a software business. They might want their software to be stored somewhere from where they should be able to install that software for their client. So when we talk about cloud storage, it's not all about backups, but you can also manipulate your data stored on the cloud. So these companies should be able to manipulate their data. So these are the three main reasons for storing on cloud. Now let's come to the point. What are the important factors which we should consider when selecting a cloud storage provider? So there are five important factors which I have listed for you. Number one is file sharing. We should be able to share our files if we wish to do so. For example, Google provides you the ability to share your files. You can get a link from your Google Drive, which is the cloud storage of Google, and you can share that link to any of your contacts, your friends, or anyone. So file sharing, file synchronization, that if I store something on my computer or on my device or on my mobile phone, that file should be automatically stored on my cloud storage. So this is synchronization. So you might have to download an application to get your file synchronized with your cloud storage. So this is another important factor, that we should be able to synchronize our data from our device to our cloud storage, from all of our devices to our cloud storage simultaneously. Now the third important reason is security of our files. The company should be able to provide our files security so that no one could get access to those files except us. Some reputable companies, their security standards are good, some are not very good, and if not good, then there are other options for you to store your files if you are more concerned about the security. So you can use some encryptor or some encryption services. So you encrypt your files and then save. So I will make another video about these encryptors, but this is another option available. If you trust the company, but you don't trust their security system, so you can do this as well. Because some people, they question Google security, or even more people are concerned about Microsoft security issues. So when we talk about security, It means that they provide our data to marketers maybe. So I'm not saying that they do this. I'm saying that some people are concerned about this. So therefore, if you are concerned about security, but you trust the company, then you can encrypt your files and then save on your cloud storage. So this is another option. Now at number four is price. We should not be paying too much for this cloud storage. Ideal situation is that we start a free plan. We should be able to get some free gigabytes. Some companies give you 5 gigabytes, some 10 gigabytes. And once you get used to this, and with the time, of course, your data will grow. You need more storage capacity. And then you must be and you should be able to upgrade to a plan. So if you don't have the ability to upgrade, then what you will do? You have to switch to another company. So we should start free, but we should have the ability to upgrade if we need. Now the last factor which I have selected for you is that we should have some application associated with our cloud storage so that we should have the ability to edit our files. For example, if I upload a Word document, I should be able to do some editing on my cloud storage. So for this, what these cloud storage providers give you, they give you some apps. So for example, Google, they have Google Docs. So in Google Docs, you can create a Word-like document. You can create a Excel-like document in Google Sheet. You can create a PowerPoint-like document in Google Slides. So Google Slides, Sheet, and Docs, these are the applications which are equivalent to Microsoft Word, Excel, or PowerPoint. So this cloud storage, Google Drive, gives you these apps associated with them. So these apps are built on Google Drive. So you can edit your document. If you upload a Word document, for example, you can edit it right inside your cloud storage, Google Drive. So the ability to edit your document. So this is another important feature we should consider. Dropbox also gives you a document like application, and I will show you in a minute. So now I will jump on my computer and I will show you a little bit brief introduction of these companies. And now what I will do is I will give you a brief overview of what are the free cloud storage options we have. So with Google Drive, you can get 15 GB free. With Microsoft OneDrive, you get 5 GB. With Dropbox, you get 2 GB. Amazon, I will show you in a minute the details of Amazon because it's a little bit complex. And MediaFire is a company where you can get actually from 10 GB to 50 GB. Up to 10 GB, you don't have to do anything. And if you want to get 50 GB, then you have to do certain things, such as they might ask you to install their app, connect with them on Facebook and Twitter, or refer your friends. So if you do these things for this company, they will offer you up to 50 GB of free storage. And now what I will do, I will give you a brief overview or a quick tour of these four options, which are the most popular options. I mentioned MediaFire here because it gives you a very large gigabyte of free storage. So I thought it's worth mentioning them. Otherwise, there are a lot of companies, but these four top companies are the most reliable and a common option. And now we will have a quick look at these four. Now let's have a look at Dropbox. Dropbox was one of my earliest favorites, but now I don't use it because they only offer 2 GB, which is not enough for me. So I opened this account today just for this video. And if you click here, you can see that they offer only 2 GB. But this is a very good and user-friendly cloud storage platform. And they also have application. So if you click on create new file, you can create a new file with Google Docs, Google Sheets, Google Slides, and they also have their own Google Docs like application, which is called Dropbox Paper. So you can edit your files in here. You can create your files Word like document here as well. Then you also have the ability to use Microsoft applications, Word, Excel, PowerPoint. So these are a lot of options, and it's a very good storage platform. If 2 GB is sufficient for you, you should go for it. I would recommend, it's a very user-friendly platform. As you have many options here for upload, you just click on upload files, and then any of the file, let's say I click on this file and I say open, it will show you this dialog box and it will ask you where you want to upload. So I just click on Dropbox, and upload. So this is how you upload files to Dropbox. You can also upload folder. Just click on this and select a folder. And now, for example, you want to share this file. So come here and click share. Now, there are two ways you can share a document. You can share for only editing, or you can share for viewing. And you can select any of these. Then you put the email of that person here, and then you should be able to create a link. So this was one way of sharing. The other way is you can send this via Gmail. So if I click on that, it will open my Gmail and it will put the link in the email. So you can send to anyone. So this was a brief tour of Dropbox. So let's talk about Amazon. For this, you have to visit this website, aws amazon web services.amazon.com. And since we are looking for free products, so we click on pricing and then AWS free. Here you can notice that we have two types of free products. One are those which are always free, and one are those which are free for 12 months. This is just the first difference you will notice here. But there are many other things to watch out. Let's first check this 12 months free. We are only interested in storage. So this is a storage product, Amazon S3, which is the standard product. S3 stands for Simple Storage Service. It gives you 5 GB of free storage and then this much get requests and put requests. This is another storage product, and we will not talk about this because Amazon has a lot of products. The important thing for you to note when you're using Amazon is that you have to make few decisions. You have to check whether you will be needing those files on a regular basis, or you want to store this for a longer period of time. Because on Amazon, after this free storage and these free get and put requests, you have to pay for any retrieval of data. And that payment is few cents for a gigabyte, let's say. But still, it's few cents for a gigabyte you have to pay. So therefore, you should consider whether you will be needing those files on a regular basis, because then you have to pay more. But if you don't need those files, and those files are only for archival purpose or for storage backup purpose, these decisions you have to made first when using Amazon services. This is their standard service, which is only free for 12 months. Now, if I click on always free, and let's uncheck this so we don't see these things. For this always free, we are only interested in storage. So this is the storage section, and on storage section we have Amazon Glacier. And this Glacier product is always free. But the problem here is that you should only store your archive type of data, which you don't need very urgently. That type of data you should be storing here, because the retrieval is very expensive. There are two things. One is that you have to pay for retrieval, and the second thing is that that retrieval will take some time. For example, maybe 4 hours, because the purpose is to store this data for a longer period of time. So you have to select whether you want Glacier or the standard S3 product. Mostly Amazon is used by big companies. So this was a brief introduction. Now let us quickly have a look at OneDrive. This is my OneDrive account. You just need a Microsoft Hotmail account, and you might need to download this OneDrive app on your computer, and then you just log in into OneDrive with your Hotmail account, and you will see something like this. And to upload a file to your OneDrive, you simply click on upload. You can upload files and folders. Very simple. Just click on files, for example, and then select a file and click open. So I have been using OneDrive for nearly 2 years now, and I don't use it as my main storage, because they only give you 5 GB, as you can see on the left hand side. So for my main storage, I use Google Drive. You can also create files here by clicking on new, and then you can create a Word document, Excel document, or PowerPoint, and all these options are available. I think they used to give 15 GB free, but now they only offer 5 GB, but it is absolutely free. This is a brief tour of Google Drive. With every Gmail account, you get 15 GB of free storage from Google. This is one of my newly created account. So this drive has 3 sections. As you can see, the first section is quick access, in which these are the files which I have recently accessed. Then folder section, in which I have only one folder, and then the file section, in which these are the files which I have in root of my Google Drive. So if I upload a file now, it will be uploaded in my root. If I want to upload in a folder, I will click on this folder, and now if I upload, it will be uploaded in this folder. So let us upload a file. So in order to upload a file, you right click on this area and then upload files. So let us assume I want to upload this audio file. So this is a small file, open. And on the right hand side, you will see this dialog box, which will show you that this file is being uploaded and how much time is left. And you will see a circle on the right hand side, and this circle is completing. And when it will be completed, you will see a tick sign. And now as you can see that we have a white tick in a green circle, and this is our file. So it means that file has been uploaded, and you will also get this message, one upload complete. Now let's go back to our drive. Google provides you a lot of applications, and if you click on this new, you can create a Google document, a Google sheet, or Google slide. You also have some other tools. For example, this Google drawing is very important, and Google forms. You can create shapes, flow charts, flow diagrams using Google drawings. So you have the ability to edit your documents. So let us assume that I want to share this document. So I right click on this document and I press share, and I will get this dialog box. Now I can type an email here. So I can type any email and I can add more people, and when finished, I can click send. And now an email will be sent to that person regarding this share. And the email will say something like invitation to edit. Let's go back once again. There are three levels of access. One is the full access, can edit. The other level is can comment, and the lowest level is just to give the view access. Currently, I have assigned the edit access. You can change all this if you want. If I click on advanced now, I will get this dialog box, and now you can see that this document has been shared by this person. If I want, I can remove the access from here. Just click here. If I click here, it will be removed. I have to save the changes. If I save changes, now the access has been removed. So this is how you upload a document, give access to someone, or remove access from someone of your documents. So this was a brief tour of Google Drive. I have recently launched a course on Google Docs, and I will put a link in the description for my 200 YouTube subscribers who will join this course first. This course is free. So just click on the link and you will be taken to the Udemy website, where you can enroll in the course for free. No credit card payment or anything is required, only 200 subscribers. Make sure that you subscribe first.
So I hope you like this video. If so, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. See you next time.